The state of water bodies in cities like Hyderabad and Bengaluru is testament to chaotic urbanization, rampant construction, lack of proper legislation and apathy of citizens. Amidst this, the recent transformation of Neknampur Lake bears witness to a sustainable solution to the contamination of water bodies. Neknampur Lake, also called Ibrahim Bagh Chinna Cherivu, is a 25-acre water body situated in Rangareddy district, Telangana. As the story often goes, this lake too used to be a de facto sewage dump for the adjacent Alkapur township and a garbage dump for the surrounding villages, until Dhruvansh, an environmental NGO, initiated the restoration process in June 2016.
From last 1.5 year while working on this lake, it was really typical because it was completely a garbage dump, sewage water lake. We got a very big dead bodies, a lot of dead bodies of animals, human beings, everybody was available over there.
The common solutions for these problems are diverting sewage or installing a sewage treatment plant.
That sewage diversion is not at all the solution of the lakes, because if you are doing a sewage diversion, you can save this particular water body, but you are actually polluting some other water body. If you are using STP, then STP has a very high cost, maintenance cost also, and plus it does not remove pathogens and metallic content. It only removes sludge.
So the team has constructed a biological sewage treatment plant with the combination of water hyacinth, floating treatment wetlands, aerators and mass plantations around the lake. The floating treatment wetland, spread across 3,000 square feet, was inaugurated on February 2, 2018 on World Wetlands Day. With 3,500 saplings, it has been recognized as the largest floating treatment wetland in India by the Indian Book of Records.
Here what we have done, we have first created a matrix of the bamboo. On that matrix of the bamboo, we have put a plastic sheet based. And above that, we have used styrofoams which are covered into the layers of plastic sheets. Now, after the styrofoam base, we have put the gravels, and on those gravels, we have put the wetland plants. Now, these plants' roots are directly taking nitrates and phosphates from the water, and plus these particular floating island or these wetland plants are giving competition also to the water hyacinth. So it is the competition for the nitrates and phosphates among the floating island and floating aquatic plants.
Another unique feature of the restoration process is their use of water hyacinth for cleaning the lake. It is usually seen as a problem because it chokes water bodies and destroys other aquatic life. The cleared hyacinth mixed with cow dung is being used as organic manure to grow plants. The combination of all these natural resources have yielded good results.
When we started working on this lake, the BOD was 28, the oxygen was 0, the nitrates was 27, and the phosphate was 7. Now, with the Telangana Pollution Control Board, we have BOD as 3.2. We have dissolved oxygen as 4.5. We have phosphates 0.5 and nitrates 8. So the result is actually very good.
This sewage treatment plant has also enriched the local biodiversity, supporting 178 species of birds, 41 species of reptiles, and many mammals whose numbers are increasing day by day. Many students come here to learn about the science behind the cleaning process, and they also take part in the revival of the lake.
It was a completely water hyacinth finished one, and it was sewage lake. And now after 1.5 year, I have seen this a lake, beautiful one, and it has become a tourist spot even. I have seen many of people visiting this lake.